Thank you very much. Thank you very much. We are Jazz Ensemble One. We're so glad to be here opening this evening for the Symphonic Band. Thank you so much for coming out on behalf of the School of Music, College of Design, and the Institute. Really appreciate you supporting our live musicians and students here at Georgia Tech. We open with a tune entitled Apollo's Reel by Tom Moulter, and that featured Ian right here on the guitar. Yeah. Reed on the alto saxophone. And the band on the tune. What a cool tune. Thank you very much. Thank you. We're going to move on to a tune that's written a little bit more recently by Zach Rich. It's a little bit more of a modern contemporary tune entitled Let Me Clarify. We hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
Anthony Groff on the trombone. Yeah, give it up, give it up. Reed, alto saxophone. Daniel on the piano. The rhythm section, Kevin, Lawrence, Christian. Thank you so much. All right, we're gonna get to a portion of the show that I'm calling the Koji Kondo Suite. Now, how many of you guys have ever heard of Koji Kondo? Yeah, I figure. Now you're not as old as me. See, I grew up with the original Atari, the Nintendo 64, the Nintendo DS, right? The original. And so the next two we're gonna play come straight out of that lineage. Anybody ever played Super Mario 64? Yeah, I played it growing up along with Pong. Remember the old Pong game? And I would set it, and if we get stuck in the middle, my mom would get so mad at me. Nonetheless, I digress. We're excited to play a couple of tunes for you tonight. The first one is written and arranged by Charlie Rosen of the 8-Bit Big Band out of New York. This is a great chart, yeah, a lot of fun. And then we're gonna have a premiere. One of our students has written an amazing arrangement of another Koji Kondo tune that you're gonna hear a little bit later. But without any further ado, we're gonna do our first one called Bob Omb Battlefield from Super Mario. Thank you. Jeremy on the tenor saxophone. Give it up. The band, Mario. And Wario in the rhythm section, too. We have them all. Princess music back there. All right, we're going to move on. We have some amazing faculty members here at Georgia Tech, and we're really excited to have a great new faculty member joining us this year. A lot of new faculty members joining us this year, but the next gentleman that's going to come out is a fabulous jazz trombonist and performer, and I really wanted to take an opportunity to feature him this evening. So if we welcome one of our newest professors here, Jeff Albert on the trombone. This is a beautiful, one of the most beautiful melodies we really have in the jazz lineage, entitled Polka Dots and Moonbeams. This particular arrangement was done for the Stan Kenton Orchestra, a really well-known jazz ensemble of the 50s, 60s, 70s, and the 40s as well, and arranged by the legendary Bill Holman. So we hope you enjoy our treatment of Polka Dots and Moonbeams.
Thank you.
Jeff Albert, trombone. Come on, give it up, big round. Thank you so much. Yeah, we're very fortunate at the Institute to just have really diverse, I think, faculty backgrounds, experiences, educators, also performers, and I think that's so important for our students to also, you know, educate, but be able to demonstrate that artistry, that professional approach to music making is so important. Okay, oh boy. All right, so this gentleman, amazing person, musician. We've had a couple of students in the last year that have been writing music, and he came up over the summer, if he doesn't break everything before he gets up here. And over the summer, he sent me this piece and said, hey, I've been working on it, check it out, and I turned it on. And I immediately texted Mace, and I'm like, this piece is great, like legit, like great, like really awesome. And so we've worked on it, we've worked through it, and I told him, if your piece, you're running the band, I'm gonna go play in the trumpet section. So we're gonna have a good time tonight. Malik's gonna talk very quickly about his piece, It can be a little long-winded sometimes. And we're gonna have a great time, a lot of soloists, but I'll give it up to Malik, please.
Thank you. It all started when I was 9. Well, really, the story is I love Zelda, and I heard the Afro-Latin Jazz Orchestra this summer in New York absolutely destroy this free concert, Bryant Park. And I was like, I think, like, oh, maybe I could do that. No, I could not. But this is the closest I'm going to get. So I want to say a big thank you to these guys for dealing with me and dealing with this new music. I mean, it's been a pleasure working with them. And without any further ado, let's play Grudo Valley. One, two, three, four.
about this guy. Malik, yeah! Woo! Yes. Thank you so much. Amazing. We're so fortunate to have so many talented performers and musicians at Tech that are not even majoring in music, but you guys are all that talented. It's super cool. Thank you so much. One last tune, very quick. Very famous tune by John Coltrane. Moment's Notice, arrangement Alan Baylock. We'll do a very quick set change and then be ready for the symphonic band. They are doing West Side Story. It is awesome and it's massive. You're going to really enjoy it. So one more piece. Thank you so much for supporting live music and us at Georgia Tech. And off we go with Moment's Notice. Thank you, Jazz Ensemble. Thank you. Thank you very much. All right, give us just a couple minutes. We'll switch out the set.
Thank you. All right, I promised them I'd talk for a minute to give their face a break after that. So we started the piece, or the concert, with a piece called Melodious Thunk, which is inspired by Thelonious Monk, who's a great jazz pianist. And of course, that was the masterpiece, Symphonic Dances from West Side Story, by Leonard Bernstein. One of the, actually probably the only piece of music from a Broadway show that has made its way regularly to the concert stage. And because it is such a great masterpiece of all these different songs and dances from that show, that is just obviously incredible music. We want to thank you for being here tonight. We also, it's great to be joined by the jazz band, who did an incredible job. And so obviously we're reaching the end of the semester, and with Thanksgiving coming up, and let me brag on them for a second, specifically about West Side Story. I warned them, and I continued to warn them, right, from the very beginning, that is 22 minutes of as hard a music as you can play. And we had 9 rehearsals. This group, all the ensembles, rehearse 2.5 hours a week. That's all. The jazz band, the orchestra, the 2 concert bands, the choirs, that's about a third, maybe, of what you would have at most music schools, at least in a traditional way. That's about 11 and a half hours of rehearsal for this. And so it's just, it makes me incredibly proud that they dig in and just go to work and just play something so incredible and so beautiful. And so I just want to say that, and I'm just incredibly proud of their hard work and their musicality, and it's just a joy to be on stage with them. Please. So on that same note, I want to take a second and recognize our graduating members of the band. Is anybody? I know Wyatt. Oh, and Michael, that's right. Yes. Yeah, so I said on Tuesday that at the concert band and Jazz 2 concert that, that's really a great thing that is, a lot of these people are in other things. They're in marching band, they're in symphonic or concert band or whatever. And as I said, it's a great way to end the day is with music, even if you have to go take a physics test after that sometimes. Right? We had that on Tuesday. We had people coming straight from a physics test. We're going to finish the program with a piece by Carolyn Brimmer, and I promise the alliteration Beaton, Bender, Bernstein, and Brimmer was completely unintentional. That was not on purpose. This is a piece called Early Light, and it's from like the late 1990s. It's inspired by the national anthem, but it has kind of a unique focus. It's the composer specifically says, don't take any, overt super patriotism or anything. It's literally because she loved baseball, and the last thing that happened before the baseball game was the national anthem. So this is Carolyn Brimmer's Early Light. Thank you.
Thank you.